Alright, looks like we are live, and we're playing some Ace Combat Zero with a special little twist. I've got myself a HOTAS set up, or HOTAS, I don't really know what the colloquial term for it is, hands-on throttle and stick. In other words, I've got a joystick and a neat little throttle rudder.
I know him.
And I'm going to fly this for maximum immersion.
It happened years ago.
Going with the... cockpit view only.
Kind of aces.
Let's enjoy the cutscene.
Those who seek strength, those who live for pride, and those who can read the tide of battle. Those are the three. And him?
He was a fighter pilot they called Solo Wing Pixy. This man was his buddy. He is the man I seek.
It was a cold and snowy day.
Who is the victim, and who is the aggressor? And what is peace?
Foulke fighters approaching. Shoot them down and secure your superiority. They've got the greatest of the doors. Time to hunt some wild dogs. These are round table fighters. Stay sharp. The round table's nothing special. I'll take care of things.
I love those, like, opening trailer setups. Let's start the game, shall we? Alright. Campaign. Oh, bother. Alright, well, guess we'll just do it on hard. It's alright. Hard is my preferred difficulty on the classic series. Just because it puts you at the same damage threshold as enemy planes.
Oh,
and I like that.
Yeah. I know him. It's going to take a while. It happened years ago. Did you know there are three kind of aces? Those who seek strength. Those who live for pride. And those who can read the tide of battle. Those are the three. And him? He was a true ace.
He was a fighter pilot they called Solo Wing Pixy. He was a colleague of the man I seek. 10 years ago, there was a war that engulfed the world. The Belkan War. And in that war was a pilot who trailed across the sky and disappeared from history. He was a lone mercenary who inspired both fear and admiration. He is the man I seek. And so... with the words of Solo Wing, the curtain rises.
It was a cold and snowy day.
Okay.
Listen up. We have a situation.
Got our first mission.
A major squadron of Belkan bombers has crossed our border, and it's making its way here, to Valet Air Base. Apparently, they intend to attack our base in an initiative to gain a hegemony over the entire Republic of Ustio. Blay Air Base is our country's last line of defense. If our base falls, no one will be left to stop Belka from taking over Ustio. Your mission is to destroy the squad of bombers and defend our base. Belka's invasion must end here.
Alright, so it wouldn't be Ace Combat if it didn't start out with the last line of defense against a bunch of bombers. Some of these are older ones. They're rocking in old-ass Russian stuff aside from the B-52s. Yep. You got the Tiger, the Draken, and the F-1. Man, I like my F-5s. So let's go with that. A little bit of emulation warping, but not a big deal. Do I want to be a mercenary, a knight, or a soldier? Well, let's just play it by ear. Alright, first things first, let's let Percy and Pixy off the leash. Got our cockpit view. Stick and rudder's working, so is throttle. Let's fucking go. Let's see what the first guy's gonna do. Yank, yank. Alright. Gonna connect? Yes, they will. Perfect. Alright, now we go for our bombers. I think we're gonna do a little bit of a dive in on them like so. So actually, one thing I really like about this setup, I have my map set up on a dial because it was, he's gonna joust. That was a mistake. I have it set up on a dial because on the PS2, it was a analog control. Ooh, Pixy nailed one. Good job. So now I can just have a little dial and just have a specific setting for it. And I kind of like that. He's going up behind. Maybe get a little bit of speed so I can kind of evade it. No, you don't get. Do we let him escape? No. I don't think I'm going to take out civilian targets, but I'm just going to shoot down anything that's militarily significant. Pixie's nailing him. No escape for you. You're not getting away.
They'll talk about us for years if we can take all these guys out. Watch out, the enemy's locked onto you. Nothing was said about this in the mission briefing. Seems like they have a quality pilot within them.
This actually controls pretty nicely. I'm a little surprised. It's going to take a little bit of getting used to, but... Oh, damn, Pixy just wiped out all the mission targets while I was fighting everyone. Oh, it's so refreshing coming from Ace Combat 7 and suddenly just having a wingman that... Not only is he, like, competent, but if you aren't on your toes, he can actually outdo you early on. I actually really like the feel of this. This is also sort of practice to do this for Ace Combat 7. 7's a lot more frantic, whereas this one's a bit more cautious.
It all started on that snowy day. My first impression was he had potential.
Yeah, Ace Combat's single player mode is a lot more hectic. There's a lot more targets, there's a lot more missiles flying at you. So, flying with a HOTAS, I tried it a couple times, it was a bit iffy. I need to get more used to using one. I honestly haven't had one ever. Can I see how many Pixy got? I can't.
The Belkan War is shrouded in mystery. But now, a decade after the peace accords, a portion of the records was finally released. I quickly got a hold of it. Wanting more details, I acquired information from unknown sources. There was a reason for my obsession. The roots of the war lie in the Belkan Federal Law Review that took place in 1988. Belka, suffering from economic strife, permitted its eastern territory to secede, and the Republic of Ustio was born. But Belka's economic troubles did not subside. Meanwhile, taking advantage of the situation, the world superpower Osea continued to flourish. Amidst the economic panic, an extreme right-wing party took power within Belka, aiming to restore strength and stability to the nation. And on March 25th, 1995, with the discovery of natural resources in Ustio, Belka began to invade its neighbors. It was the beginning of the Belkan War. Unprepared, each country fell quickly before the might of the legendary Belkan Air Force. In just a few days, they occupied all territories except for the mountain range. In response, the occupied Ustio government military placed all their hopes on a joint operation between Osea and the foreign mercenary forces. This, of course, can be found in any history book. But I noticed a strange similarity in the materials I gathered. There were several accounts about a mercenary, all followed by the code word, demon. But most of the information was incomplete. Still, I was intrigued. I decided to pursue the history of the Belkan War through this mercenary. I was certain I would find something there. Would it be the hidden truth behind the war, or just another battlefield legend? I wasn't able to meet the mercenary himself. Actually, it's questionable if he ever did exist. But thanks to some old friends in the military, I was able to track down several individuals who knew him. Soloing is one such man.
All right, round two.
We must regain control over Route 171, which runs through Ireland, to secure a transit route for our ground troops. There are bridges along this route, three over the Ara River, all heavily guarded by the Belkan Armored Corps. Securing this route is critical to Ustio's attack on the Belkan forces. Destroy the Belkan ground units blocking. blocking passage along this route and secure the supply line between our forces and the Ocean Army.
All right, good old-fashioned ground pounding. These missions are kind of fun. I tend to like furballs a bit more, but I'm not going to say no. Let's go back and get ourselves some toys for the Draken. Tough choice. I'm going to go with Bomb. Let's do this.
Tom 1, you are cleared for takeoff.
Come on, get that speed up, baby. I was about to say, Draken's supposed to be good for short takeoff. Too used to Ace Combat 7s.
Tom 1, altitude restrictions canceled. Return to your mission. Good luck.
I do like this flight model better though. It feels a bit heavier. And that's nice. Especially with a HOTAS.
This is AWACS Eagle Eye to GOM. The target is in formation along the highway. Commence the operation.
Keep an eye on us up there, AWACS.
Falcon ground forces are blocking off our transport route. Destroy them all.
A little slow on the lock on there.
They must be in a desperate situation. There's no way we're giving up this place. This route is Usio's lifeline. I'll get it back.
Yeah, we'll leave the windmill. We're not total monsters. Another one neutralized.
Approaching gun range.
Hi, Pixy.
It's no good. I can't get back up.
Radar lock. AA guns destroyed.
Okay, nice. High speed bomb pass. I think it whiffed over the high end. Whoops. Nailed it.
Tank destroyed.
Here they come again. 3 o'clock.
I'll take the fighter that's going to engage me. If he wants to play, I'll play. Let's try that again. Bombs good.
The operation is proceeding smoothly. Eliminate the remaining forces.
Gun range.
Missile launched.
Ooh, precision strikes at speed. Fun times. Behind you.
Bandits
in gun range. Alright, now you can go ham on these ground targets with impunity. And there we go.
Operation complete. Now the Allied forces can secure a military transport route. Well done, GOM team. Looks like luck was on your side again today, Solo Wing.
Yeah, well, I've had my fill of going home without wings. Alright, job well done. Sorta. Starting to get used to this setup. It's nice.
The mission was a success.
Little twitchy. It's hard to stay level. But fun.
Thanks to you, Ustio will now be able to launch a counterattack.
Oh, and I'm a goody two-shoes. Yeah, that'll change. That'll change after some more folks get wounded.
Head Operations has issued an emergency order for a reconnaissance mission conducted near the border. You will be monitoring the airspace B7R, currently under Belgian control.
Strong opposition. Yes, the best area in the game.
And the presence of a magnetic field has been detected, which may interfere with communications. In short, this will not be a walk in the park. The B7R airspace is located above an area rich in subterranean resources, where many conflicts have been fought in the past. You're authorized to engage enemy planes upon contact. Time has come for your skills to be tested.
Do I have any aircraft that I can buy? MiG-21. Yeah, let's take a fish bed to the fight. If I'm going to be fighting the Knight Aces, I'm going to be dealing with Gripens. That'll be a good time.
Belkin Priority 1 Strategic Airspace B7R, aka the Round Table. It was the grand stage where we pilots performed. We were all on an equal footing, fighting under the same conditions. No affiliations or ranks to hinder us. Aces from every nation crisscrossed through those skies in pursuit of air superiority. The only rule of engagement was to survive.
Alright, let's go.
This is Eagle Eye. Penetrate B7R and get a feel for the surroundings.
Call 2, roger. This kind of job is what we're all about.
Enemies on radar. Exercise caution.
Like these two boys off to the side are going to be coming for us first.
It seems they're on to us.
Comm team, engage.
Let's party.
We will survive, Comm 1.
Comm 1, missile launched.
Bank, accelerate, and slow up fast. Those aren't looking too positive, too good. Pixy got him, though. This furball on the road.
Let's see what those planes are made of.
Steel, aluminum, a little bit of titanium if we're getting fancy.
Radar lock.
Now's our chance. Don't let them get away.
Oh. I even had the shoot icon and everything. Out, or at least a stall. Come on. You won't outslow me.
Locked on.
All damaged planes disengage.
Warning, the enemy's locked on to you.
Or Pixy will just get him off my. Thank God for competent wingmen. Sometimes I'm not competent. Alright, well, that's all of them.
Additional craft approaching area B7R at high speed.
Call 2 to Call 1. Enemy reinforcements, probably the main force.
And here we go.
Indigo 1 to all units. Target spotted. Commencing attack.
Let's go, Belkins. Fucking crank the intercept music.
Watch
telling me to shoot, so I'll shoot. One down. Pixy, show me what you can do with this guy. House, I'll take him. Pixy, you're just spamming that poor fellow. Nah, we'll play fair. No need for... Pixy is just sending him at that guy. That looks like death for him. Oh, nope. Nope. He's turning.
Bandits in gun range. Radar lock. Missed. Locked on. Golem one, box two.
You know, I am impressed by this guy. He is just holding on. There's like legitimately some good piloting from him. Looks like he got tired.
All Belkin reinforcements confirmed down. Mission complete. Return to base. Incoming message from Allied Forces Operations Command. Allied Naval Force has begun its advance. We appreciate your work.
And we were just a fucking distraction. Cause you know, mercenaries.
Seems B7R is more heavily guarded than we thought. If it wasn't for you, this ploy of ours probably would have failed. Keep up the good work.
And we're back into soldier territory. And we got a griping. I don't know why it's saying it's unformatted, but...
and Ocean Coalition forces are to launch a joint campaign. The collective strategic military force of the two armies will be referred to as the Allied Forces. The campaign will be called Offensive Campaign No. 4101. The objective of this operation is to secure a sea transit lane for the Allied Forces. To secure this channel, the Belkan forces occupying the Futuro Canal must be cleared out. You will be given a choice of missions in this joint operation. Offensive Campaign No. 4101 will be comprised of the following three air missions. First, there is Operation Gelnikos. This is an air-to-air surface operation, whose objective is to wipe out Belka's air squadron, port facilities, and surface weapons. Next is Operation Round Hammer. This is an air-to-surface operation, whose objective is to wipe out the Belkan fleet, its port facilities, and surface weapons. And the last mission is called Operation Costa. This is an escort mission, whose objective is to protect the naval vessels in Osea's Third Fleet, including its state-of-the-art aircraft carrier, which will be making a trial voyage. Fierce resistance by Belkan forces is expected in all three missions. Choose carefully which one you wish to participate in.
Alright, so we got an air-to-air, an air-to-surface, well, an air-to-air escort, an air-to-surface, and a mixed. I think I'm gonna go mixed. All I can really buy is the Gryphon C. You know what, let's take ye old... Use the F5, use the F35. Let's go with the good old F1. excuse me. Oh, this is interesting to look around in. Very wide. And they got jammers.
Secure a route of passage for the Allied fleet.
Alright, well.
I've made visual contact with Futuro Canal.
Oh boy, Stalin. You're sneaking up behind me.
Radar lock.
I don't appreciate that.
How does he want to protect that fleet behind us? I know how you think, Cipher.
Oh. It's like Pixy deleted him.
Locked on.
Don't let that air squadron get in close. What we need is a bomb angry bird overhead.
Damn it. Thought that was a bomb reticle for a second. These jammers need to go.
Locked on.
Prepare to engage aircraft.
Cipher, don't underestimate the Belkans. They'll do anything it takes to protect that canal.
Second air squadron has already left.
Enemy armored vehicle destroyed.
Ah, it just hits him. Oh, I can see. I can murder. Jet. A dragon. All right.
Don't panic. We're still
Rockets are really hard to use with this setup. Just nail their shit a little bit more and then.
Halt and rotate the gun turret. Adjust your sight.
Gom one, missile launch.
Sir, turn right.
Watch out.
We're gonna call it dick move. We're just gonna kind of carpet some of their bullshit.
Forces eliminated. Nice work, GOM team. This should make your next operation a whole lot easier.
Mission success confirmed. Allied fleet, begin your advance.
Mission successful.
We appreciate the great air support.
Yep, so direct fire weapons are tricky with this setup. Not impossible, but tricky.
Operation Gelnikos, campaign number 4101 was a success.
Oh, and I got the first plane that I actually really want. I like the MiG-29. It's a good plane. Good jet.
The mountain town of Solus Ortus is located just outside Ustio's capital, Directus. The Allied forces will deploy airborne troops, comprised primarily of Osea's 101st Airborne Division, over Solus Ortus, in a surprise air and ground attack on the Balkan forces. This operation will play a critical role in Ustio's liberation. Your mission is to provide support for the airborne troops. Destroy Belka's surface-to-air defense network and all interceptor aircraft, securing a safe drop zone for the airborne troops. Be aware of civilians still inside Solus Ortus. Your actions will determine their fate. Good luck.
All right. So I'll try to avoid hitting any civilian targets. Emphasis on try.
Okay.
Yeah, paratroopers are fucking hardcore. Like, I don't care what you say. I would not want to piss one off. This is the type of person who jumps out of a perfectly good aircraft into bullets. Crash there. This might end with me getting shot down. Ooh, that was a little close. A little close for comfort. Tell me about it.
AA guns destroyed. Locked on. Missile warning.
Call 2 engaging. Missile turning to evade. Enemy confirmed down. That's a kill for Gall 1.
Who saved your ass, Gall 2? Shit, they're going for the target. Hold them off.
Mayday, mayday, mayday. Requesting support.
Yep, I'm coming, buddy.
Our allies' support operation is going as planned. Continue on with your duties.
Let's get you on at it. Pixy gets the last one. Damn it. Didn't want to spare them.
Your lift operation was a success. All enemy forces near Solus Ortus have been eliminated. The rest is up to the ground forces. GOM team, mission complete. Return to base.
Alright, let's just do this at ludicrous speed. Pretty sure that's not how you're supposed to land, but the landing gear can take it. It's very bouncy.
Operation Varsity succeeded. Ground troops are now en route to Solus Ortus. It won't be long now before Ustio is liberated.
Okay.
Preparations to liberate Directus are now complete. I I will now brief you on the Usio 6th Air Division's role in regaining control of the capital. Directness is divided into five administrative wards, centering on the River Driscaren. Powerful weapons have been placed in each ward, comprising the Belkan Army's Usio Branch headquarters. This battle will determine our fate, as the annihilation of all enemy forces will mean liberation for the nation of Usio. The enemy forces are primarily comprised of ground troops, but we have received information that, while not yet confirmed, there is also a squadron of high-tech enemy fighters.
Hint, hint, I guess.
Your orders are to destroy the Belkan forces and liberate Directus. We can't afford to lose.
I think my best bet is going to be the MiG again. I don't want to reuse planes. Mirage is good. Still can't quite afford the... Yeah, fuck it. Going French on these boys. I do like the music for this mission as well. I like the music for all the missions in this game.
Release five sectors under Belkan control.
Cipher, let's do this right. The battle's going in our favor.
Radar lock.
Good hits.
Enemy armored vehicle destroyed.
Give me a damage report.
Radar lock. Weapons release.
Alright, now we go do some MiG hunting. You're climbing, why are you climbing for?
Abandoned area 2, reposition the battlefront immediately. The tide should turn once they get their capital city back.
Hurry up and get this bird in the air, we've already lost this city. I don't care, just get us the hell out of Directus. The Belkan chopper is leaving.
Oh, that chopper's not getting away. Fucking coward. This guy's gonna hide among the city.
Thank you.
Oh god, I'm an idiot. No jamming. I'm not a fan. Ooh. He was going for danger close with that one. Fuck those tents. Gotta shave that weight for what's coming up. I don't think that actually affects Ace Combat though, but the thought counts. These crazy bastards.
They're faster than anything we've come across. Commence intercept.
Flying up. Okay. See how that works for you. On my tail, which makes it messy. That's right. Hit the brakes and he flew right by. I pulled a Maverick, motherfucker. Come at me. Speed advantage, though.
I know Cipher and Pixy can get the job done. Radar lock. Box two.
Enemy. Gotcha. I can't believe they hit the brakes and they fly right by actually worked. Oh, that makes me so happy.
May 13th, 1995, Ustio was finally liberated. The tide of war was about to change dramatically.
Oh, That felt good.
Velka's Ustio branch headquarters has fallen. Directus has been liberated. I just received a vintage bottle of Chateau Bouloise for the GOM team. It's a hard-to-find Cabernet.
Getting fancy.
Perfect, I'd say, for celebrating an occasion such as this.